Hello everybody, welcome back to another episode of Train Simulator DLC Spotlight. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the... Sorry, it's a little bit loud. I'll stop when it does. We're going to be taking a look at the A2 class Blue Peter DLC, which I did pick up in the sale, and I am quite glad that I did, because from what I've... Well, from how I've been... messing around. I've done the scenarios I need to, but I've been messing around with it as well. This thing hauls ass. Like, seriously, it is really, really quick. I'm just going to put that on running to shut it up. Right, so we've got to go now. Now, I'm going to get it going and then I'm going to start talking because it's... She can be a bit temperamental to get started. I've found... In fact, quite temperamental. Just want to make sure that it runs nicely. Okay, so we're going to go in here. Just turn these on, just because I can. I'll get onto that in a minute when it's when she's going a little bit faster. Well, I have got the realistic mode on. Because that's the mode that it selected for this scenario. So I'm going to try and beat my previous score, which already I'm doing, because I got more than minus 25 last time because of wheel slip. But never mind, let's go to the back. Flashing light. That looks weird. Never mind. Oh, live overhead wires, and you get fried like a frog. Right, let's turn it back up. Nope, not having that. Again, very temperamental. But anyway, yeah, this is the LNER, as it's advertised on the Steam page, LNER A2 Blue Peter add-on. There is only one locomotive in the pack, which is Blue Peter. However, that is on the UK train sim. There's a reskin for another locomotive as well. Just gonna check it. Checking all day. Red. Oh, we've got a yellow up there. Okay. So it's better I stay inside the cab. But anyway.
Let's pull my door a bit more too.
There we go. And I'm also gonna remove one of my headphones. I've got a lot of USB things plugged in at the minute, so. Okay. Right, so about this locomotive, everyone who knows about British Steam will probably know about Blue Peter. I've mentioned the 1994 kind of like calamity that happened with Blue Peter, subject to priming and the cylinders in the front here. Oop, thanks for that, HST. The cylinders here, they just exploded, more or less, causing a couple thousand pounds worth of damage. Couple hundred thousand pounds worth of damage, sorry. Let's readjust my headphones because it's already sliding off my head, but never mind. But yeah, as you can see, I mean, underway, not that long, like 3 minutes, already up to 50 miles an hour. And for me in a steam train, that is not bad in this game. It's not that the physics of this game are bad, that's one thing this game does very well. It's the mechanics and everything are really, 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 really well done. And I'll be doing another video, soon in the new year, highlighting something I feel I should have done a while ago. So look out for that. I might seem a bit further away from the microphone today, but that's because I've got a new chair. because my other one, it broke. There's no other way of putting it. It broke, so I had to get a new one. But yeah, so what is included in this pack? You get the locomotive, which is quite nicely done. Actually, it does look quite nice, doesn't it? Looks very much like Tornado, but the A1 to A3s look fairly similar. And then you got the A4s, which are just streamlined and, well, mallard basically. It's got a tarpaulin as well. It's got a tarpaulin, which you don't see on Tornado, I don't think. Oh, no, there it is. Not there. There. But yeah, it's done in a nice amount of detail. Got working lights in here as well. This I found useful, especially when going through tunnels, but on a bright day like this, especially at 25 to 4 in the game, it's not needed, but it's nice for when you're in tunnels. One of them is these little things, these little metal things, and then the other ones are the big ones. As far as I can tell, there are things on the top, but they're vents, which I have as yet been unable to open. I do have automatic fireman on, purely because I'm crap at firing a locomotive. I really am. But yeah, I found this locomotive very temperamental sometimes. The window's already open, which is quite nice. I can stick my head out, but hello. But yeah, it's quite temperamental in terms of wheel slip. It's probably the locomotive I found the most wheel slip with, which I quite like because it's got a bit more realism in it, which is quite nice. I'm also going to try and shut the brakes up by setting them to run, because I know I won't lose any brake pressure. That's something I found out with this locomotive as well. I could apply the brakes and then I put it on running and it holds it at that pressure, which I did not know. Which must make me sound like an absolute noob. I've been playing this game since it was Railworks, so I'm one iteration out. I came in on like the second generation of this game. I don't know how many generations it's gone into now. I don't know what, it's up to 2016 and I don't know what it's at. That's another thing. I love the particles on the funnel as well. They've done that really nicely. So they actually come out separately instead of like just in a clump, which is quite nice. The safety valves, I'm not sure if I've actually seen them be used on this locomotive yet. I'm not sure. Oh, the headlights. Oh, Jesus, can I mess with these? Yes, I can. Yeah. I'm going to get the F4 menu up for this because there are 11 types of lights. I'm going to go through them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. And they are ridiculous. I think I had that one. Let's go back one. There we go, let's change back to the F3 menu. But yeah, the lights are quite diverse. You can basically have any sort of train, whether it be freight, passenger, express, stopping train, whatever. You can have that on here. They're getting better. Although whistle's quite nice as well. That's one of the things I like about this locomotive. It doesn't have a bell whistle. It doesn't have a bell whistle, and it gives it a kind of unique thing away from the bell whistle of the A4, bell whistle of the Tornado. But well, actually, the Flying Scotsman currently got a bell whistle, but that's because they haven't been able to record any sounds for the Flying Scotsman because it is currently being completed, and it's not actually that far away from completion because it's doing its steam trials in January on the East Lancashire Railway, which, if I can find out if it's quite close, I may go and watch that before I go back to university, which will be quite nice. I also have a week at university where I will be... I'm going back a week before I start, so I'm hoping to have a few videos for you as well, and they will be the user-requested ones that I've more recently been able to look back and catch up with, because my first semester of university basically turned my brain to mush, and over the past week, I've been back around a week, so that's something that I'd like to get caught up with. is some user requested content, which I've been able to, I can oblige to it a lot more with the sales. I mean, I'm still hoping for one more Steam voucher, so I can get just a little bit more. I may get the Streamline Coronation Class, I don't know yet. It was either this or the Coronation Class, and I was like, oh, I want to complete the collection, because now I have A1, A2, A3 and A4. I've got a lot, which is quite cool. They don't seem to put much up about upcoming stuff, other than when it's in the game. Oh, I've just found... It's the throttle. There's the throttle. Oh my god, I've only just noticed that. That is so cool. I'm going to leave it at about 80, actually. I never noticed that. Oh my god. There's just some things you never know until you look at it in a little bit more detail, which I'm kind of glad I've done with this lockup, because it's actually really nice locomotive. But yeah, she goes like the absolute clappers. 10 minutes, 80 mile, easily. Rocketing at 80 miles an hour. The reason you can hear the AWS, I believe it's called this, AWS advanced warning system. That's a bit off, but I'll talk about that in a minute. It's because the driver's window's open, which is quite helpful, especially when you're trying to do something like this. You want to capture like different types of shots, or even doing it for thumbnails. It's like you're absolutely chipping it down the line, and chipping it at 80, 90 miles an hour, and you're just trying to get a really nice shot for the thumbnail, which you'll be happy to know I've already done. So that's something that's quite nice. There's no white outline either, which I also find quite nice. Yeah, this locomotive, it's really nice. One thing I will penalise it for is this. If you've seen Tornado, you know that that will move forward and that will pull back to blow the whistle, which it does not in this, unfortunately. It's a small detail, but it adds a little bit more. Like the throttle turns. What the hell is that? Oh! Never spotted that either. That's quite interesting, actually. You've got the loco brake, the locomotive brake, the train brake, the reverser. Where do you think the sander is? There? Wrong. It's there. Which actually quite surprised me. On a lot of them, the sander is just on the side of there. You just pull back and the sand comes out, but no, it's there. And a lot of pipe work. And you got the cylinder box over there. You can do stuff with the firebox, but I can't at the minute because I've got an automatic fireman, and I daren't try and mess with it. Do I have a timed slot for this? Yes, it's in 2 minutes and it's 5 minutes. Oh, Jesus. This is my problem. Sometimes I just get talking and I get into something too much and it's just like, oh my god. And then I miss something. It's like, I don't put the reverse down so I can accelerate more. It's just a pain in the ass. Okay, so this is like... Yeah, I do that to try and find where the nice spots are for the reverser. To get going a bit faster. But yeah, positives, it is a really nice locomotive. Animations are smooth as fuck. Like, seriously, they are so nice. As far as I'm aware, everything moves. I'm just looking here now to see if these move, and it does look like they do move from that little judder, so that's quite good. It's hard to tell from here, because it's going really fast. Because they can't make... Oops, I was whistling, probably. Oh well, I'll whistle, it's fine. Jimmy will be fine. He gets a free ride to London. I picked Jimmy. Yeah, it's got the crest on there. Yeah, Doncaster in 1948. It's got the obligatory show code designation. It's got British Railways. I think that's the... Early Crest. I'm going to say Early Crest, and I'm more than likely going to be wrong, but never mind. But yeah, it's got the tarpaulin, which is quite nice. I don't think you see the tarpaulin on Tornado, if memory serves. If memory doesn't serve, then I am a complete and utter idiot. But never mind. But yeah, it's really nice. There's hidden details. I mean, I've spotted something recently with a bit with a few pieces of DLC you can see right through there, which is not something that you'd usually want to look at, but me studying to make this kind of stuff, you kind of pick it up. But some things I will penalise, other things I will not, because it's me being extremely picky as a game artist. So that's one thing that I do pick up on. One thing I don't understand though is, like, you've got nice resolution there, nice resolution here, and then there's these. It's like, that's nice, and then you got that. I mean, you know what it says because you know the look of it, but I don't get why they're such low resolution. That's something I don't understand. But oh well, I probably never will. Yeah, the wood's nice, maybe a little bit better. It does look like, it does look a bit soft. Looks a little bit soft. They've got splatters on here, which is quite nice. Someone spilled the coffee, someone spilled, I don't know, like some ketchup, hot chocolate, some soup, something like that. Then I'm gonna probably just get the shovel and cook some bacon in the fire, but never mind. I don't know what this thing does. It hasn't seemed to have affected anything when I've been messing with it. Really, but I'd rather not mess with it, to be perfectly honest. Oh, I'm late. Bollocks. You do still get plus points, but you don't get as many if you're like a minute late. Oh, I'm 2 minutes late. Bigger bollocks. Never mind. This seems to be the London to Peterborough route, which this scenario currently runs on. It seems to be the only one that I can get Blue Peter above 90, I believe. It's like, I'll put some footage up of this scenario where I've had it easily going at 90-91 mile an hour very happily, and the speedo is pretty much spot on. I mean, it's a bit off there, but yeah, the animations in here are really nice. That's just really like sharp because the AI is doing it for me. Apologies for the brief yawn. My sleeping pattern has completely gone to shit since I've been back. I've just been trying to get my brain back into a normal condition, really, after more or less being melted. Which is something, I guess, but never mind. Right, so as we swoop under this viaduct at 90 miles an hour. Look how bloody fast she is. Absolutely ridiculous, and that is while hauling 13 Mark 1s, which you also get in the pack. They are Cream and Carmine, or Blood and Custard as they're more affectionately known. Because that does look like blood, doesn't it? I don't know about that for custard, though. Usually the custardite's a bit more yellow. I mean, like, if it's homemade custard, then maybe, I don't know. Oh, yeah! You get this as well. You get an inside view. Also, I think if you press shift... No, if you press one of the... I think if you press 5 and it doesn't have one of the... As you can go inside, it will put you on here. It will put you in the brake coach. It's quite cool. It's not, like, one of the things to do. I don't know. We got the flashing light that's obligatory on it. Every Dota Games Mark 1 now. We are on the express line, which is quite nice, even though we are stopping at Hitchin in about 10 minutes. Which works quite well for this video. That's one of the reasons I put this scenario. It works really well for this video. Because I was sick of just running willy-nilly and not having an objective. Because now I've actually got something to aim for, so you can see just how either average, bad, or good I am at this. I wish they had like a fireman mode on this. It's like there'd be a driver, and then you'd just have to keep maintain the locomotive rather than you driving and maintaining everything else. I saw a whistle thing. Yep. That's a bad habit I've picked up from driving American locomotives, just in general, actually, for that matter. Is the too long to show on a long whistle or horn? I think the sign's a bit further back. Yeah, it was there, because I'm going a hell of a lot faster. The sound's muffled in here, and I'm not sure why. Surely it would be louder in here if you're right beside it. Well, you're right behind, basically, the... I don't know. 100 ton piece of metal that you're currently having to run at 90 miles an hour. 91 miles an hour, there we go. But yeah, absolutely, she runs really nicely. It's ridiculous. She can proper go for it. I just want to check on what PSI can get it down to. Because the true PSI is on the F5 menu. Right, let's not have that. Let's keep it at that. Just turn the brakes off. See, the regulator's at 99, but on the F3 one it's 100. That's a bug I hope they fix. So. Also having to do this around. I'm going to do this like around my family being home as well, because they've booked a few days off because it's New Year's Eve. I promised you a video before New Year, and you will get one. This is what it will be, and then I'm hoping to have 3 or 4 videos done before I start university again. So that'll be hopefully one, well, every month is 4 weeks, maybe one bi-weekly. Just so that you guys have actually got some content from me, which I've been lacking over the past 3 months, which I do apologise for, but at the minute my university studies have to come first, because it's my third and final year and I do not want to fuck this up. I really don't. Yeah, it runs really nicely, sounds really nice as well. Like I said, it goes by the absolute clappers, which is never a bad thing. You can do like shuttle whistles with manually. Which is quite nice. That's, you can add like your own cut. I find that quite entertaining sometimes, but yeah, more or less everything you see in the camp you can touch. Apart from these, I don't know what these do. I'd rather not touch them, to be honest. It's just these. I can screw around with them, and maybe them. I think they're for the water. There's a water scoop somewhere. Oh, you do. Oh, let me do something with you. I don't know. I'm assuming there's one under here as well. Oh yeah, there's 3 cameras. Oh, hello. Friendly electric box. Never spotted that before either. Yeah, over here. Dent in there for some reason. I don't know. Something needs to happen, maybe. Never mind. Yeah, you got. Oh, these are. I think these are like boiler working pressure. Yeah, there's boiler pressure, and that's. I'm not sure what that one is. Never mind. How are we doing? Good. We have slowed down. And 30 seems to be a good one for speed for this locomotive. And then if you press it again, you get the middle of it where you can only go up and down, which is pretty cool anyway. You basically just sat on here while everyone else runs around. It does give you the scale though quite nicely. It does scale it pretty nice. Because it's actually quite small. When you go here, it looks huge. Go here, it looks huge. Go here, yeah, it's pretty small. Especially this box, but yeah, you can get this stuff there, which is fairly nice and useful. Do I have any gripes with it? Well, it's really a gripe with like every locomotive at the minute, is like headboards. I wish they had some headboards. There may be, I don't know, I haven't really looked at the manual. It's just the fact of play around with it and off you go. But yeah, not a lot of coal in there. Yeah, you can see the detail in the tender, which is not something you usually get to see when I do these videos, because I usually have a full tender. But again, not upstairs. Yeah, another gripe is they don't have like the embossed text on there. I mean, I can see why, but it's just it's like the little things that make it a bit more. But yeah, it's basically the same as Tornado, but it's. Well, I can get it going fast. I can get it going faster, which is quite nice. It doesn't affect the frame rate at all. Only the roots affect the frame rate, really. And my next video will be on a the next DLC spotlight will be on a root as well as a locomotive, which has been requested. Which I'm quite excited to do because it's one I picked up in the sale and I haven't actually looked at yet. So it'll be pretty damn cool to do so. And I will let you ponder or scour the comment section of every other video I've ever made to look for that. So yeah, I'm going to come on to my final thoughts as I go here, which I'm going late for. I don't know about that. That I could possibly do 12 miles in 10 minutes. I'm doing over 60, I could probably get that. I got a very bad score though. But never mind. So one of my final thoughts on this, it is a very nice locomotive. It runs really nicely, it goes really fast, which is something you expect from steam locomotives. Especially if you're trying to put them up against diesels. It's like, yeah, locomotives can do it just as well, so shut up. Well, I got more points for that. Oh yes, just within 55. Yes. Awesome. What's the next one? 3 miles in a minute-ish. You'll see at the top it says A2 Blue Peter at the starting gate. It's the first scenario on the grey mode, which is why I'm getting points for it as well. I don't know if there's any standard scenarios. I don't think so. They've seemed to have come away from doing standard scenarios and standard, usually user-created ones, which are kind of seem hard to find. I can't really find them fairly easily. They might need to update their filtering system, but yeah, things for the past. Again, it's got a 3D cab, which is nice. Got the two blocks in there. They must really get paid a lot. They drive a lot of steam locomotives. Jesus. Yeah, it's really well done. It's been really nicely done. There's a few niggles here and there, but every product does. Yeah, another yawn. God damn it. I woke up like 4 hours ago. And it's 5:45. Put it this way, if they can't see me coming, then they're blind, really. Unless they are actually blind, in which case I should probably use this. So, okay. I'll think about that on the next thing. So, the extras to it, they are the lights. Lights are very nice extras. I don't know what the little ones do. I think they're like the red ones. I don't know. But yeah, the lights on the inside of the cab, so if it's getting a bit dingy, you can just turn them on. You can have both on, which has a little bit more light. The frame rate does seem to tank a bit when you have them on, but it's nice. Got even more points now. The next one is a hitching platform. So I will finish. I'll finish the scenario for this video. But I will say this, if there is any pieces of DLC that you want me to look at, and you can just say a route, you can say a locomotive. If you say a locomotive, I'm more just a locomotive, I'm more inclined to choose the route. But if you have a locomotive and a route, then I would be very happy to do so. As a couple of videos coming up in the new year shall be that. Shall be just that. If I do not have them in my Steam library, I unfortunately won't be able to accommodate, but I shall do my best. Apologies for that, I just hit my microphone because I'm a complete and utter moron. Yeah, we're doing a good 90 mile an hour. We've got to get, not wrong one, it's that one. We've got to get 7 miles in just under 7 minutes, about 6 minutes. There we go, about 7.5 miles in 6 minutes. 5 minutes. Ooh. Might be a stretch. I don't know. We'll see. I'm kind of like in the middle ground at the minute. So I can do a mile and a half every minute right now. If I'm right, because I'm right between 120 and 60, so I should be able to make that. It says depart 1605, but that's another scenario. That's number two, which is quite nice. It follows on. Although I do wish they had bigger scenarios, really. It's like a couple of hours long. And like even just like shunting these things around, that'd be quite nice. I mean, I know they're for like smaller locomotives. I've done a few smaller locomotives, but it'd be quite nice to have like big ones. Big ones being moved about for like maintenance and stuff like that. But yeah, my final thoughts. Really well done. Sounds really nice as well. Goes like the absolute clappers. There could be a bit more variation in the rolling stock. Seems to be just repainted Mark 1s. And again, there could be more A2s because there was just more than one. Although they do seem to be doing just preserved steam locomotives now. Which have Flying Scotsman, no other A3s like Flying Fox, Flying King. Again, with the A4s, there's only six of them when there was a lot more than that. They didn't have the original four. Silver Link, Silver Fox, Silver King, and Silverfish. Finally remembered them all after seeing the army versions of them in a shop in Manchester. Last week before, something like that. But yeah, it's still quite nice. I will be downloading that, the repaint, the reskin of another, I think it's Trimbush? No, Pearl Diver, I think. Either way, I'll find it on the internet and I will put it in the description for you. What will also be in the description will be, well, that's weird, the link for this DLC, the link for the game, and again, any routes, any locos you want me to see, you want to see me waffle about, have a look out for the first time maybe, and just basically, yeah, just blabber, waffle, all of the above, ramble, then feel free to put it in the comments below. If I can oblige, then I will be more than happy to do so. Unfortunately, if I do not have it, then I can't oblige. I apologise. But yeah, the first piece of Dovetail DLC I've looked at for a bit, I think. Yeah, because I was looking at Just Trains for quite a while. I haven't looked at their Christmas sale, actually. Might be worth a look. I don't know. But we've got 2 miles to go, 3 minutes, so I like doing these half hour, 40 minute videos. I mean, they may be a bit of a pain in the ass to watch. If you want me to do shorter videos on them, then I will be happy to do that. I'll be happy to oblige. But I mean, I like doing the long videos. I mean, I might do more scenarios while doing these things because it would bring a bit more of a point to them as well, wouldn't it? I don't know if there's... Oh, Jesus Christ. Right, keep an eye on the brake pressure. Keep an eye on the brake pressure. Let's have it at 13, should you say. Yeah. No, maybe a little bit more. I always... Oh, Jesus. Yeah, that's one thing that always gets me. I think it was... I'm like, what the fuck is that? Oh, Jesus. Yeah, as we get closer to stations and more populated things, the frame rate does tank a bit. Especially on bigger routes. I do have another route, actually, which I may take a look. Which I do own. I've had a bit of a go on it. But it's quite long. Jesus. Shut up. Yeah, that's because we're coming into a platform from an express line. I don't get why it's... Oh, it's because I'm changing over. Again, I'm a master. I think I can release the brakes. No, I can't. A bit more. I hope I'm running. Well, they're on all the way now. Release them a bit. There we go. And as we come into the station, with the gallant Blue Peter saw a bit of a jitter there as the animation changes to accommodate for the bogey swerving. I should probably put the brakes on again. Let's see if I can get this. No, I wanted to press 3, didn't I? Yes. I may actually get this. I may actually get this pretty damn nicely. If I do, I will be more than amazed. Ah, so close. But never mind. That's the end of the scenario, and it's also the end of the video. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any other comments about this, then feel free to leave them below. Again, if you want to request locomotives and routes, again, put it in the comments below. I shall have a look when I get the chance, and I will be able to put videos out when I have spare time. There will be a few new videos out in the new year before I start university again for my third and, well, for my second part of my final year. So videos will be scarce around there. I do apologise, but again, my current education has come first. But yeah, I would like to thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you next time.